And the Rakhi Birla informed the local
police. You're showing proactive
in local police knew about the case.
In demanding suspension of the police officers, but you
gone.
Never showed any proactivism while the Danish woman was gang raped.
Okay, one second, Ragini, let him complete his point.
What are you talking about?
Let him complete. Ragini, one second, let him complete. He'll complete and then you speak.
Let me finish. I'm talking about a case in Sagarpur, Rakhi Birla case. A woman was, it was informed to the police that she has been threatened, she might be burned. DCP knew about it. SHO knew about it. Nothing was done. And finally, the woman was burned. The woman was burned with 45% injury.
So?
She is still admitted in the Safdarjung Road, Safdarjung Hospital.
So now my point is, what is the remedy? One second. Ashutosh, I'll tell you this today. Ashutosh, I'll tell you today. I'll tell you today. You answer me, Ashutosh. Though this is not me. I ask you today. A chief minister and his supporters break the law. They violate the curfew. You, with your actions, force 3,251 police personnel to monitor your dharna when they should be deployed elsewhere, providing security to the people. Then you pin the blame on the central government if there are any problems in the Republic Day parade. God forbid today if the enemies of this country take advantage.
Absolutely.
I'm asking you today, this anarchism is not your private property, Ashutosh. If the enemies of this country take advantage of the security situation that you are knowingly creating, will you and Arvind Kejriwal take responsibility for it? Will you? 3,500 and...
Will you listen to me?
3,200 plus policemen are there guarding your dharna today.
Arnab, can I come
People
in
are on the edge.
I need to make two quick points.
Arnab, I'm sorry to say this. Till now, I have known that you are a democrat. Now your high-sounding words smells of a dictator.
Really? Anyone who doesn't agree with you is a dictator? So I agree with you, I'll become a democrat?
Look who's talking here.
That dharna, agitation, demonstration, and fast. These are all
okay, so I'll tell you one thing. Okay, Subramaniam Swami wants to counter
you.
Subramaniam Swami wants to counter you. I have a counter to that. I'll remind you.
No.
You know. I'll tell you. Ashutosh, I have one counter.
Going back to Subramaniam Swami, you have to give me time to respond to what he asked me.
No, go ahead. I just want to remind one thing to Ashutosh, my friend, who has just called me a dictator today. Ashutosh, I never thought the day would come when you would call me a dictator because I disagree with you. Now, I'll just tell you this, Ashutosh. During the launch of the Aam Aadmi Party, Arvind Kejriwal was asked, why are you forming a political party? And he said, because the Andolan route does not work long term. Street protests don't work, governance works, and that's why I am joining politics. Today, he's challenged, within 2 weeks, he's questioned his own logic. Anyway, Ragini, what is the point you wanted to make to Ashutosh?
See, two points I want to make. See, all this gimmickry, this halaboo, this drama, this tamasha, this dharna is nothing but an effort to sustain the momentum that the Aam Aadmi Party gained in the recently held Delhi elections. Now, they very well know after the flip-flops of the last 20 years that they cannot sustain this momentum through effective governance, through delivering what they have promised. That is why they have to create a scene, they have to gain the sympathy of the people, they have to posture before the camera, and they have to present themselves as martyrs. Only then they would be able to actually
score only
points and gain some advantage in the Lok Sabha elections.
Okay, one second.
And I also want to say here that this...
You're supporting them. That's fine hypocrisy from your side. You support them.
I want to say
you support them.
He has a myopic view.
Where do you stand? You have no standing on this issue.
Yeah, now
I can say today that you are supporting them till the point they don't come after you. You are supporting them till they don't come after you.
Let me answer.
No, Subramaniam Swami as well. Subramaniam Swami has a counter to Ragini. Subramaniam Swami.
I have to answer. Let me answer. I'm coming to what Mr. Subramaniam Swami asked me. See, as far as the Congress party is concerned, there are no two standards. There are no two stands that we have taken. There's no confusion apart from that which Mr. Subramaniam Swami wanted to create through misinterpretation and through the use of his semantics. The point is that the Congress party was clear as daylight on its stand. We have supported the Aam Aadmi Party on the 18 issues that they put forth in their manifesto. veto on which the people of Delhi have voted for them and for the implementation of which the Congress party has given them support, not just
really?
Support, but a fair chance to deliver what they have promised. But
No, you that's that, complete and utter hypocrisy. That's utter hypocrisy, Ragini. Hypocrisy. I call that hypocrisy, Ragini. That's your hypocrisy.
Ragini, one second. We have every right to register our
Ragini,
protest.
Come on, don't be hypocritical. Don't be hypocritical.
It is not hypocrisy.
Don't be hypocritical. You listen to me. Ragini, your party calls.
President of Congress.
Ragini, your party calls.
Categorically said.
Ragini.
Also play the role of opposition.
Ragini. Ragini P. Chidambaram.
Positive and
P. Chidambaram says.
The manifesto.
P.
These are two different things.
Now you see, I can't. No, remember this. You know, Ragini, now one second. Give me some patient hearing here, okay? You say they are Jurassic. Aam Aadmi Party. You say they smell of anarchy. Don't say today. You have no right, I say today, to accuse them when they say we are anarchists. Because when you decided to support them, you knew they were anarchists. Today, Ashutosh is declaring his support for anarchism as a political philosophy on the channel. You knew they were anarchists. Salman Khurshid said they are Jurassic. They are anarchic. They demean everything that is time-tested. They ridicule everything. They question and demean everything.
There were reasons.
No.
There were reasons
to support anarchists. Did you know they were anarchists?
The sentiment of the people.
Really? People wanted anarchism?
We did not want the people to be burdened.
People wanted anarchy? People wanted anarchy?
There was a clear-cut mandate in favor of BJP.
People wanted anarchy.
They ran away from the constitution.
This is fantastic. Ragini, listen to the question, Ragini. Don't just make your statements, Ragini.
But you're not entitled to concoction of facts and misinterpretation.
I disagree.
Your interpretation.
I disagree.
You have every right to
I
do
disagree
that.
Thoroughly
I,
with you.
I am not
concocting a single fact.
You might
I am quoting. I am everybody. You can say anything to me. Ashutosh calls me a dictator. You say I'm concocting facts. So between all this name-calling, I say tonight, if I am concocting facts, you don't know your facts. You go and find out what Salman Khurshid said. These are Salman Khurshid's facts and his words. I challenge you today on the program. I'll call Salman Khurshid live and he will tell you, yes, I call them anarchists. And he said they are anarchists either by choice or by ignorance. We ask you tonight, to the Congress party.
I'm not countering what you're saying as a fact, what you're presenting as
now you're backing off.
Salman Khurshid's words. What I'm saying is.
Oh, so if I say it, it's bad, but if Salman Khurshid says it's correct.
I am being hypocritical today. I have double standards. I have objections on that.
You.
What I'm saying is, you are entitled to your opinion.
Did
your
you know? One sec. On the program tonight, by the way.
But you can't put words into my mouth.
No, I'm not. By the way, you know, Ashutosh on the program today has said, and this is the controversial point. He said, yes, go into the definition of anarchy and anarchism. We have to debate that tonight because this is a party that wants to fight a national election. When you fight a national election, the country wants stability, not anarchy. That's all. That's limited point. Sunil Alag wanted to counter you on something. Ashutosh, yes.
No,
Sunil Alag to Ashutosh.
You know, I want to get away from the Congress BJP fight. I want to state
mean you are? You are very much part of the Modi camp,
yes,
and you say
not,
I want to get away from the Congress
BJP
fight.
Yes, I'm stating that.
So what do you want to get into the Modi Kejriwal fight?
No, I want to stick to the point that was being made today. As far as I'm concerned.
Are you representing the views of Mr. Modi or not?
One second, not the views of Mr. Modi. I am saying Mr. Kejriwal is either too smart or too simple. Okay, one second. For one reason alone, he has no respect for India because he has no respect for
factual,
the defense.
Factual.
Why is he doing this 3 days before the Republic Day? The question that I'm asking is, he is beginning to realize that he cannot govern. So the best way is either I will go into this anarchy mode and Congress will remove their support. So I go back to the streets, which is all right. He either decides to be a CM or decides to be a Anna. He cannot be both. That's all I'm saying as far as I'm concerned. He's a very honest man and I like Ashutosh and I like Kejriwal. But the process and the system that he's following, the means to the end is all wrong.
So political party. So here's a question, right? Subramaniam Swamy. Okay, you have a counter. So Ashutosh is the counter. Go ahead.
Right.
Ashutosh.
See, Mr. Alag, it looks very nice to hear your words. You know, you have said he has no respect for India.
Correct.
And can't govern. I don't know what is the definition of governance in your
eyes. Because let him sit and govern Delhi. My definition is, why doesn't he govern Delhi? Why is he getting out of Delhi and trying to go into a national level without having any policy?
Let him complete.
Okay, fair enough.
I wasn't disturbing you. What do you mean by governance? You want to give me the model of Gujarat? When the sticks and the minorities are changed?
I began by saying I don't want to get into the BJP Congress fight.
Let him respond to you.
No. You are telling me.
I will define governance for you. As a citizen of India, I'll define it for you. I will define it for you as a citizen of India, not Gujarat model. I do not want a system where any minister takes law into his own hands. Full stop. Good governance is following the law and process of India. Please, that's what I define governance as. Not Gujarat model, not Japan model, not Germany model, not USSR, not China. I am saying governance is not taking law into your own hands. And y'all are doing that. That for me is bad. Y'all don't care about India because you don't worry about our image outside. Let me do it on Republic Day. Let the whole world see. I am going to create Egypt. I'm going to make a Tahrir Square. I'm going to do Syria, and to hell with anybody else. That is what I'm against. So do not think I'm talking about.
One second, a challenge has been thrown. He's asked you a question on Gujarat. That's all right. Everybody has their right to have their point of view.
That's it.
No, but I want to challenge. Here's my question too. One second, please. Ashutosh, you quoted the Oxford Dictionary.
Yeah.
I quote to you tonight the Webster's Dictionary. And the Webster's Dictionary, which I have respect for, Ashutosh. You're going into your Google search. Yeah. Go ahead, Ashutosh. If it helps you and you don't trust me for quoting it correctly. Ashutosh doesn't trust me. He thinks I'll give a wrong definition. Ashutosh, I told you at the start, you may disagree with the way I ask you the questions. I'm never wrong on fact. The definition of anarchy as per the Webster's Dictionary, for the information of Ashutosh and the purpose of our debate on the News Hour tonight, is this, ladies and gentlemen. And I ask you tonight, do you want this? A situation of confusion and wild behavior in which the people in a country, group, organization, etc. are not controlled by rules or laws. A wild situation, a situation of confusion. Think about it, Ashutosh. You, by supporting this, have painted yourself into a corner, and you will defend yourself on the other side, though you are defending the indefensible tonight. A situation of confusion and wild behavior in which people in a country are not controlled by rules or by laws. If Arvind Kejriwal says he's an anarchist, do you want that state of anarchy? Back after a few minutes on News Hour Debate 2, continuing, and Ashutosh is not going anywhere. Yes.